Jesus is teaching about the eye as the lamp of the body is placed, it's related. It's placed in a section about how we take care of your material possessions. And so the claim that if your eye is full of light is not just a general idea about living a pure life or a clean life. It's about whether or not you take care of your material possessions in such a way that you are generous to others and kind to others. But I do want to take it in that more obvious sense about the idea that the eye is the lamp of the body. And if your eye is bright, if your eye is full of light, then your whole body is. Because we can say this about our entire body. And I'm thinking this week especially about the need for our mouths to speak the truth. As my kids read the book Animal Farm, we talked a lot about the way that totalitarian dictators begin their work by telling lies, by making separate connection between what they say and what they actually do. There was actually a joke in Stalin's Russia where they said, oh, we already know the future. We've written it. It's the past that keeps changing because their lies pile up on lies, and that's the only basis of the dictator. Adolf Hitler, of course, only comes to power because he stages all of these crimes and claimed that it was communists or claimed that it was Jews, but in fact it was his own operators. The whole thing is founded on lies. And of course, a little bit closer to home, the great Thucydides, when he writes about the plague that afflicted Athens in the 5th century, he says one of the first things that happens is that demagogues try to wield authority over the people, and they take their panic, and they start to make night day, they start to make darkness light, they make truth falsehood, and falsehood the truth. Words no longer mean anything. People are just talking. I feel like we're in one of these moments now. But it's not only confined to the strange pandemic that has afflicted our world. It's not only confined to political problems that face us. This is a general issue, and there's really nothing new about it. This is actually a wonderful thing that history, and especially studying the history of philosophy, teaches you. There's no new idea under the sun. There's a circular quality. Things just keep popping up, and this is why we want to study the past, and it's why we want to learn from the past, because we see ways that our own lives today can be improved. And the one thing that I want to talk about, I began with totalitarian dictators, but only to make a point. Because one of the things that afflicts us today is that our institutions are largely corrupted. People whose mouths are supposed to speak truth don't. It's impossible, of course, to speak from a perfectly objective place, right? But I feel like all of our news media is driven by biases and agendas. You have to read 10 different things to figure out what happened. People who are supposed to be experts are later found out to have put their finger on a scale so that the thing that they told us from the perspective of experts couldn't really be trusted. And the reason Stalin is on my mind is that we watched a movie this week that was connected to George Orwell's Animal Farm Weekly about a journalist who uncovered the way that Stalin was letting millions and millions of Ukrainians die so he could take their wheat and pump up his economy. And this very famous American columnist, Walter Durant, he won a Pulitzer Prize for his reporting on the Soviet Union, and it was all lies. The people who were supposed to be trusted are lying to us. Too often, I'm not conspiracy theory, I'm not being crazy, what I'm saying to you is this. It's always wrong to lie. It's especially wrong to lie if you're a teacher or a leader matters more. When a priest or a hierarchy is caught in corruption, it seems to hurt more. We're supposed to trust these people. I say all this to remind us that we're supposed to speak the truth. We're supposed to connect very closely what we think, what we claim to believe, and how we act in our lives. If we don't, the light in us is really darkness. It's all just a charade. It's all just a game. It's all just about power. And there is no truth, and there is no reality. But we, of course, know that there is a truth, and there is a reality. And we should just smile and laugh when we see things around us that are lies. We have to make them recognize this is what happens. It's the human condition. But we can't fall into this. We have to avoid this. One of the most beautiful teachings of the New Testament is, let your yes be yes, and your no be no. Let people know what you think. What was happening. Sometimes you have to be careful so you don't hurt feelings. Sometimes you have to be careful so you don't cause so much trouble. But don't live a lie. Live the truth. Let the light shine forth in you. Because if we're right that Jesus Christ is God, and if we're right that we're his followers, then it's our job to spread his light in the world. And if we don't, the light doesn't shine. The light is supposed to illuminate the world.